First, to the latest coming in on the Jalalabad attack. The so-called Islamic State has claimed responsibility for the suicide attack in Afghanistan that killed 19 people, including 17 members of Afghanistan's Sikh minority. Another 20 people were wounded in the attack, which was claimed by the Islamic State group. The blast on Sunday damaged shops and buildings around Mukhbarat Square. The bombing came hours after Afghanistan President Ashraf Ghani inaugurated a hospital in the city, the provincial capital of Nangarhar. Police say that the suicide bomber targeted a vehicle carrying members of the Sikh minority who were travelling to meet the president. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in a tweet, strongly condemned the attack. He said, and I'm quoting, "We strongly condemn the terror attacks in Afghanistan yesterday. They are an attack on Afghanistan's multicultural fabric. My thoughts are with the bereaved families. I pray that the injured recover soon. India stands ready to assist the Afghanistan government in this sad hour," unquote.
شهیدانم د اهل ونود مشران دي کې چې وکړه چې رئیس جمهور سره ملاقات وکړي کله چې د منطقې ته رسیدي د انتجار کې په محل واقع کې
یو دفعه ګړمباشو یو ګاډي کې وکیل صاحب هم ناست و میرسنگ پلار هم ناست و کلندر ټول ناست و بس همدلته یو فری انتظار ټول هلته عسکر ولاړو موږ هغو ته چیغونه وا چې راشه موږ سره داونی سه یو څوک هم مخکې نه شو یو یوازې زه پروت یوازې هم ګاډي نه کته شم نور یو څوک هم مخکې نه شو
شل تنه ټپیان او د نن نسلونو وژل شو جسدونه راوړل شوي چې دوه پکې مسلمانان لستنه پیژندل شوی څکانه وتنه تر اوسه موږ سره مجلوی دي په وژل شو کې د اهلي هنودو د پارلمان یا ولسی جرګې نومان او تر څنګه شامل دي.
India's Foreign Minister Sushma Swaraj also tweeted on the incident, and I'm quoting, "My heartfelt condolences to the families of the victims of the terror attack in Jalalabad city of Afghanistan. We are with them in this hour of tragedy. I am meeting their relatives today at 6 p.m. in Jawaharlal Nehru Bhavan."
Avtar Singh was a true Afghan patriot, a person who was to represent the small minority population of Sikhs and Hindus in Afghanistan. He was to represent in the upcoming elections. Afghanistan goes to election on 20th of October. He died in that terrible terror attack in Jalalabad. He was in touch with WION for an interview. His last words to WION was he was going to represent the Afghan Sikh and Hindu community. He is going to demand the rights of the minority population from the government. He recently met our ambassador Vinay Kumar in Kabul and was also the representative of the Kabul Gurdwara Association. Now this terror attack has taken place against a minority population. Once the Sikh and the Hindu population was growing and it was around 1,70,000. After the Taliban rule, there was a steady deterioration. And today the Afghan Sikh and Hindu community just stand at 1,000 in number. The world, especially Afghanistan, is going to remember Avtar Singh, a man who stood for Afghanistan till the very end. With video journalist Ajit Siddhan Sibyl for WION in New Delhi.
A prominent Sikh leader, Avtar Singh Khalsa, was killed in the attack. Throughout the incident, in fact, we are getting you the latest on what we know. Just last month, he had spoken to WION and told our correspondent that minorities in Afghanistan were facing hardships, and so far, no help was forthcoming from the Afghanistan government. But Khalsa was hoping to change that and planned on contesting the election to the Afghan parliament in October this year. The 52-year-old Khalsa hailed from Paktia province, located in the eastern part of Afghanistan, but lived most of his life in Kabul. His previous political experience included a stint as senator representing the minority in the upper house of the Afghan legislature. He had also served various capacities and as a senator in the Afghan legislature. He also served in the Afghan army for 10 years. He was expected to run unopposed for a seat in the lower house of the legislature that was apportioned to the minority by presidential decree in 2016. Ravel Singh, an Afghan Sikh, a civil rights activist from Jalalabad, was also killed in the attack. Afghanistan has witnessed a steady decline in the number of Sikhs in the country. The Sikh community numbered more than 80,000 in the 1970s, but today only around 1,000 remain. Avtar Singh Khalsa met with the Indian ambassador to Afghanistan recently. As head of the Kabul Gurdwara, he discussed various issues of the community's interest with the ambassador. Khalsa was a fearless champion of minority rights. Before his death, he also once said that he does not care even if he loses his life in the struggle for the rights of the Sikh community. Let's take a listen into what he had said.
Wala ke family mara tamamagi bukushan wala ke khud mara bukushan magaram taw waqt barashan mubarza kho kadam ta kya qadira changal zalim ma bukushan barashan mubarza.
And WION Siddhant Sibyl earlier had caught up with Afghanistan's ambassador to India. Take a listen in.
A terrible tragedy has happened in Jalalabad, a terrible attack in which many Sikhs have died, including Avtar Singh, who was to represent a minority community in Afghanistan. With me is the Afghan ambassador to India. Sir, welcome to WION. My first question, sir, this attack has happened. Your first words.
Well, very tragic. I'm very saddened to have heard the loss of our 17 Sikhs and one Hindu, altogether 17 lives in Afghanistan. Very tragic. As you know, Afghanistan is under attack almost on a daily basis. And we are the victims of terrorism that affects everyone, including our Afghan Hindu and Sikh community. Here we lost a bulk of our Hindu and Sikh community in Afghanistan, including the candidate, Avtar Singh, a very patriotic Afghan. I condemn it in the strongest possible words. And we hope that Afghanistan, the Afghan people, will no longer suffer from terrorism that is coming from across the border.
So Avtar Singh, a man who was to represent the minority community, the Sikh community, the Hindu community. So any words, special words for that person, a brave son of Afghanistan?
Absolutely, very patriotic. And I often visit our Afghan, Sikh and Hindu community in Delhi and Afghanistan. And I, in most cases, find them more patriotic than many Afghans I see on a daily basis. Very patriotic. They come to my embassy and they go to the Afghan government offices, and Avtar Singh, particularly when you mentioned, he was a real patriotic Afghan, and we really mourn the loss of this brave Afghan, and we wish his family, the Afghans, patience with the loss of such an irreparable one that we just came across. And we hope that Afghanistan, the world community, or friend India, will stand with Afghanistan to defend the Afghan lives. And the defense of Afghanistan is the defense of everyone, especially India and Afghanistan facing a common enemy, that is terrorism. Terrorism that is coming from the same sources. Therefore, we have to do more in order for our two nations to be safeguarded.
So can you just tell us a little bit history about the Sikhs and the Hindus in Afghanistan, what role they have played in nation building in Afghanistan, the historical role in the country?
Absolutely. They have been in all walks of life. Unfortunately, we don't have such a large number of Afghan, Hindu and Sikh community anymore. But whatever number they are in each and every field in Afghanistan. They have been in government, they have been outside the government, they've been active in the civil society, and they've been a very strong source of our democratic faith in Afghanistan. And this attack was an attack on our religious freedom. This was an attack on our diversity in Afghanistan. This was an attack on our shared values. An attack on the Indo-Afghanistan friendship, because Hindu and Afghans are the bridge. The Hindu, Sikh and Afghan are the bridge between our two nations. So we are lucky to have our Afghan Sikh community living in Afghanistan, and many of them are living in India. But they've never forgotten their country, their motherland.
So my last question, you've already spoken about terror, how it's emanating from across the border, but it seems that the countries, the states who are responsible for it, they are not mending their ways despite pressure from New Delhi and Kabul.
Absolutely. I think the world has to answer this question. It's not related to only Afghanistan and India. We have a country that sponsors terrorism and spreading all over the world. Of course, Afghanistan and India are the biggest victim of this, but the world has to answer. the terrorism that is coming to us and to the rest of the world. We hope that the world community will learn the lesson of 9/11 and many other incidents all over the world. Mm-hmm. But the sources are clear, and we hope that the world will no longer sit idle or keep quiet on the very known and very clear use of terrorism against all our nations around the world.
And Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh has also condemned the cowardly attack targeting Afghan Sikhs. In a tweet, the Chief Minister said that his government is ready to extend all the help and assistance to the victims and their families. Meanwhile, the Delhi Sikh Gurdwara Management Committee held a meeting with Afghan Sikh delegation members in Delhi on Sunday night to discuss about the situation after the attack on the community. Its chief, Manjeet Singh GK, urged the Indian government to make security arrangements for Sikhs and Hindus in Jalalabad.
Main leadership in Afghanistan is Sikhs. गुरुद्वारों के प्रधान मेन गुरुद्वारे साहब के प्रधान जिन्होंने एमपी इलेक्शन लड़नी उन्होंने 11 लोगों की लाशें मिली हैं कंफर्मेशन हुई है इस हमले में और वो राष्ट्रपति अफगानिस्तान को मिलने जा रहे थे वहां पे अपने जो उनके मिसाइल्स हैं उसके बारे में बात करने जा रहे थे और ये इतना बारबेरिक हमला उन पे हुआ हम इसकी निखेधी करते हैं गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया से हम चाहेंगे कि वहां पे जो सिख समुदाय रहता है हिंदू समुदाय रहता है उनकी सिक्योरिटी का इंतजाम किया जाए जो लोग जख्मी हैं उनकी क्या सिचुएशन है ये हमले के पीछे कौन लोग थे मुझे लगता है कि इसमें वो लोग हैं जो हिंदुस्तान और अफगानिस्तान के रिश्ते मकूल या ठीक नहीं देखना चाहते ये बहुत बड़ी साजिश के अधीन सिखों को निशाना बनाया गया